Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. If you watch my channel, you've probably realised that a lot of the astrophotos I take use one of these, a Canon EOS digital SLR. And for most of those photos, the camera's connected to one of two things. It's either connected to a prime lens, that's to say a lens of a single focal length like this one here, the 50mm Canon f1.8. Sometimes it's connected to a wide angle lens like this one, the Samyang 14mm. And now and again, you may have seen that you can produce pretty okay results using a cheap old lens like this one. So this is a 200mm lens. For the rest of the time, the camera is connected to the back of one of my telescopes, like this one, the Celestron C90. It occurred to me that I've got one other lens that I've never used for astrophotography, and it's this one. This is the kit lens that was provided with the camera when I originally bought it, and it's really stayed in its box and never been used. It's an 18-55mm lens, and even though this isn't the latest model of the lens, I've dusted it off, and the idea of this video is to see whether we can get some good astrophotos using a lens that you might already have lying around that you may have overlooked. So what can we say about the kit lens? Well, other than its range of focal lengths, I'd say the first obvious thing when you pick it up is that it's light. It weighs under 200 grams and it feels like it's a lump of plastic. That is largely because it is a lump of plastic. But that isn't to say we're going to dismiss it optically based on that. We've got to give it a test and find out how it performs. In terms of focal ratio, the lens can operate at f3.5 when it's operating as an 18mm lens. That's the fastest ratio it can operate at its most wide angle setting. And if you've got it operating like a normal kind of lens at the 55mm setting, then its speed is no quicker than f5.6. So what does that mean? Well, if we compare it as an 18mm lens to this dedicated prime lens, which is 14mm, so pretty similar, then this one operates at f3.5. Whereas this one, f2.8. So on the face of it, not a huge difference, but I guess we're going to expect quite a difference in performance just due to the different price, but we'll see. And then at the other end of the scale, if we operate it as a 55mm lens and compare it with this 50mm Nifty 50, as it's called, which is a well-known, good value and quite versatile lens from Canon, then this lens can operate at f1.8, whereas the kit lens is operating at f5.6. So that is a pretty key difference between the two lenses. Essentially, the kit lens is relatively slow. So compared to one of the prime lenses here, it's going to take more time to capture a given amount of light. And we'll see if that is a problem when we try to use it later on. Okay, other things to know? Well, the main thing is that the kit lens is from a series called the EFS range. Now, I'm not a lens expert, you can probably gather that, but one of the key differences between that range of lenses and the other lenses that I've been shown here today relates to the size of the lens when it's mounted on the body of the camera. So if you look, hopefully you can see that the kit lens here, it is going to protrude further into the camera body than this prime lens. Now, why is that significant? Well, it's only significant if you have a filter that you put inside your Canon EOS. So often I use a clip filter, which is a light pollution filter, which actually clicks inside the camera. So it's inside the body, and then normally a lens like this will screw onto the body no problem. If you try to do it with this lens, that extra distance will foul the filter and you can't actually engage the bayonet on the front of the camera. So basically the kit lens will not work with clip filters. So if you're somewhere where you have a lot of light pollution and you generally rely on a filter of that type that you've already got, then maybe that's a problem. Of course, if you've got another kind of filter arrangement, maybe one that fits over the front of the lens with a stop down ring, then that's not an issue. But for me, it is a limitation because I use the clip filter quite a lot. So what sort of results have I got using this kit lens? Well, I started off with Orion because it's currently in the middle of the winter, and I know from using the Nifty 50 that it's a good sort of size of target to capture in the field of view. So on the left, this is a single 30 second frame using the kit lens, where it's operating at round about what you might call the normal lens focal length, so 55mm. And this is a comparison between the kit lens and the Nifty 50. And I'd say, looking at it at that scale, it gives pretty good results. You've got the Orion Nebula here, and you've got reasonably good rendition of the stars. If we zoom in a bit closer, I've cropped the Orion Nebula from each of the frames, and this is where you start to see some of the issues. So for the 55mm setting on the kit lens, the brighter stars start to show a little bit of purple or blue fringing around them, and generally they're not very well defined. If we do the same for Orion's belt, we see again the blue fringing, chromatic aberration around the brighter stars, which is a little bit distracting. And then if we go to the extreme, we look in one of the corners of the field. Well, this is Betelgeuse. It's pretty distorted in the kit lens, and you can see quite a lot of the other stars in that region of the frame have got quite a bit of distortion. So from then I moved on to looking at Cassiopeia and pointing the camera much closer to the zenith at this point. And this gives you an idea of the field of view. So you can capture all of the W and quite a section over towards Perseus and the double cluster. And we're going to zoom in on a couple of sections of that frame. So firstly, near to Cassiopeia, this is Delta Cassiopeia on the right there. So here we can see from this cropped frame, we've managed to capture three deep sky objects, clusters that are within Cassiopeia. And it's, I'd say, reasonably well defined. With the exception of the bright star in Cassiopeia, the chromatic aberration is not as noticeable on the fainter stars. And if we move on to the double cluster, well, if you consider that this is a zoomed in section of the frame of a kit lens that may have cost you nothing, then I think that's quite a decent result for the Perseus double cluster. If we're going to get critical, we look in the corners as we did before with the Orion image, and we can see quite a lot of aberrations. These are not the sort of nice round star images that you'd hope to see in your perfect camera lens. So there you go, pays your money, you takes your choice, or maybe you don't pay any extra money, but it's not going to work so well at the corners of the frame. And then moving on to using the kit lens at its widest setting, so this being at 80mm, running at f3.5, so it's a big field of view, as you might expect. You can capture Auriga, Taurus, and over here we can see, I think, pretty good rendition, a nice wide angle view of this part of the sky. And then looking a bit closer onto the Seven Sisters, it, I think, records reasonably well. We don't see such noticeable chromatic aberration here at the 18mm setting, and I think that's quite a pleasing crop from the frame. And then looking at the kit lens 18mm setting, looking at the corners, the aberrations are still present to some extent, but not in any way as pronounced as when you're using the lens at 55mm. So overall, some good results amongst the bad. So conclusions. Kit lens, for me, if you've already got one of these in your cupboard, in your camera box, in your box of Astro bits that you hardly ever use, I'd say give it a try. I wouldn't go out and buy it specifically if you're looking to get an extra lens. Probably there's better homes for your money, but if you've got it already, plug it in and give it a try. For me, it's worked better at its widest angle setting with a focal length of 18mm, and I think you can get some quite nice views at that setting. Having said that, 55mm, especially if you crop a bit of the frame, it can be okay too. The main difficulty using this lens, I'd say, is because it is quite a slow focal ratio lens. It's quite hard to focus. So you've got a combination of it being quite slow. If you're using live view, which is what I recommend, it's quite hard to see any stars unless the lens is quite close to the right focus point. When you've found them, the actual adjustment of the focus ring is really fine. And once you've got it right, if you move the camera around too much, you'll nudge it and you'll lose focus. So I'd say that the focus itself is a bit fiddly. But having said that, the Nifty 50, which is a fantastic lens in my opinion, great value for money, is also a bit fiddly. And that is why you can see this fine piece of paint on the side of it here to allow me to find the focus easily. And even then, it's a bit fiddly. So the kit lens is the same. Don't expect it to be a 10-second setup. You'll have to play around with it to focus it. But if you do that and use it, maybe at the 18mm setting, I'd say you can get some good shots. Okay, I hope it's been useful. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to Jenham's Astro. Bye for now.